So we're going to move on swiftly into the passive system, which I think has its own announcement. So that's where I'm going to be going. It does. It has Naruto League character categories. Don't at me, bro. I have it right here.
What I'm gonna
read off the categories, their effects, and then we'll say which ones we thought were the best and which one we thought fell flat. We'll just go like that. First category is old/sick, so people who are disgustingly old like Danzo, or sick like Danzo,
Kimimaru,
Hiruzen, I think, what's his, there's another sick person, I can't remember. Ook, don't know, it doesn't matter. But the positive effect that they get is a free pack rat. They are also banned from Hoarder, and they get a natural defense minus 0.5. So I want to point out that there is one exception to the Hoarder rule, and that is Chiyo. Chiyo gets a free Hoarder, and that's the end of it. No one else gets a free Hoarder. The next category is Sharingan. This is characters, obviously, who have the Sharingan, not including Danzo, whoever you want to call him. They get ninja movement plus 20%. Mind you, these are supposed to be, like, marginal to, like, kind of good. So, ninja movement plus 20% is pretty solid, but it's not, like, game-breaking. So, you know, and it also is thematically correct. The next category is chakra proficiency. Characters, I don't actually know who has chakra proficiency. Does anyone know off the top of the dome piece who has a chakra proficiency?
Chakra proficiency. Boruto has it.
Boruto has chakra proficiency. That is a chakra charge rate plus 10%. Yeet. Next up is Sage. Sage Naruto. Sage Jiraiya. Sage Hashirama. Sages. Yeah? Chakra charge rate plus 10%. Yeet dab. Ban Minchin Shurugi. Gives their free chakra control, you know, because, you know, banned them. Hyuga gets a free Gentle Fist. Reminder, Gentle Fist is a awakening item that gives you chakra steal on attacks. And I think this doubles up for Hyugas. Hyugas have this naturally, and Gentle Fist doubles up, so it makes it doubly effective on Hyuga. So, you know, Team Guy buffs. Woo-ha! Curse Mark gets a free lasting energy. More like lasting debuff.
Yeah, I'm not too fond of that, but...
Straight up. Next up is Child. Gives them ninja movement plus 20%. Because, you know, they're a child, and they're excited, and they're high on sugar. But they get a defense minus 2.5, because they are pretty frail, because punching a child is not that hard.
And they're naive.
That's one of the ones that I've not had.
Minus 2.5%. I should probably differentiate that before people scream that childs are just frail. It's minus 0.5 statistically and minus 2.5% wise. Sorry. Kage gives you jutsu cost minus 7.5. Pretty solid. Giant sword. People who have, you know, Kisame, yada yada yada, Kirabi. 20% increased movement on combo starter. This is basically the effect, the movement effect on FTG in them. So, solid. And it gives ninja movement minus 20%, because that's a pretty big sword. Range fighter gets a free pack rat and banned from Hoarder. Mind you that all puppet users are under the ranged fighter category. Again, they cannot use palms. Just, it matters. Yes, they can use palms. Minus And they, as a negative, they get minus 10% to chakra dash speed. So, you know, nerf dim puppies. Renegon gives chakra charge rate plus 10%. Yinfeel gives free regenerator. Regenerator, friendly reminder.
Yes. It heals your health.
It's healing inside of awakening. So Yinfeel is the healer seal that Tsunade and Sakura use. It's that seal on her foot with the diamond. Eight gates gives a free gate of limit. Can't remember what the hell that does, but it's the awakening thing.
I think
it makes you faster, right? It makes you faster.
Gate of limit, if I'm not mistaken, it does have all movement speeds are drastically increased. If I'm not mistaken.
Sweet. It makes you super. It makes you shishui when you're in awakening. Armored. Defense plus 2.5% or 0.5. Lightweight. Ninja Dash travels 66% further. Basically, Mu, Onoki, and them. You know, the dudes who float. Lightweight. Lee. JK. Drinking. It was a joke. Taijutsu Specialist gets a free Relentless. Kenjutsu Master gets a free Relentless. For those of you that don't Naruto very well, that is, respectively, dudes who can have these hands and dudes that can have this sword. Strategist gives jutsu cost minus 7.5%. Chakra Mastery gives chakra charge rate plus 20%. I think that's a plus one.
Yeah, it is a plus one.
Is disgusting. I think Ino gets that. Hype, hype. For those of you wondering just who your characters fall under, we'll provide a link for you in the thing below. Drop down menu. What it's called. Got him. Talk about Awakenings real fast. Awakenings got a huge change this season where you have the option to put on... Awakenings are off by default. On every character on your team, you have the option to put on the one scroll that lets you awaken early, I forget the name of it.
Which
Release power lets you awakening at three-fourths of your final bar. So it's they're off by default. I want to state that. So if you want awakenings on, guys, you gotta turn them on. There is no just hope for it. This is both good and bad. Awakening is a really strong utility, but some people don't use it right. So it's for you guys. If your people don't use it right, cough, cough, my buddy Tosh over here, they don't use them right. But if you use them well, you can turn them on and it's fine. This makes team, if they're off by default and you don't turn them on, Team Ultimates have a higher chance of coming out just naturally. And remember that when you get your awakening initiated, you get your chakra back. So maybe just putting it on in the hopes that you get your chakra back in a good spot is a really good utility tool. So, you know, sweet deal. What do you guys think?
I think this is one of the better changes they've done.
I found more so than not awakenings were detrimental to most characters. So I think if you have a character that does good with their awakening, giving them something to activate it much better than the alternative.
I do overall like this whole change because people like freaking Sasuke or Orochimaru or whoever never use their awakening effectively, especially my old spammers. So unless they're forced from a team awakening, I don't have to worry about it at all.
And this can allow team ultimates as well, so you have to be super worried about that because your team awakenings suck.
it's one of those things where if you have someone that does good with their awakening, you can just make it so they can do it, and that's good. But I mean, I found a lot where characters like Asuma or
Sage,
characters butterfly. Sometimes too, whether it would be Chino or Hinata or someone else randomly awakening, that was usually the point in the match where you went down. They didn't do anything. They didn't capitalize on it. Now they have a bunch of debuffs. They're doing less damage. They're taking more damage. And that's just not a good situation to be in. So I'm actually really glad with this whole new feature.
Yeah, I am as well. I think it's very good. So we're going to close out with maps here. The new maps is a video that we'll link in the description. And we're briefly going to speak over the... we're going to speak over the video that's going to show on the screen. And if you want to see it for yourself with the music and stuff that are... I'll put a lot of work into this in the Naruto League staff, so you guys should go check out the actual video. So go in the description. It's also like the video to the right because we open this channel anyway. So whatever. But the video is going to be here. It's going to be... we're going to be talking over it. And we're all going to sync up. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, go. And it's going to be glorious. So I think first up is the Hidden Leaf Village where they're in like an intersection. I think it's from Storm 2, 3.
Storm 3 and it went away.
Yeah. So it's a returning map. Those of you who've been around for a while will know it. I unfortunately wasn't around and didn't play Storm 3, so. Yeah. But it's a pretty lengthy map. And there's a table in the corner that, like, looks like the Chunin exam stage PTSD all over again. It was a pretty quick demonstration. It's a pretty big map. And then we move again to the Boruto stage.
The future of Konoha.
The future of Konoha, where it's all, like, high-tech and shit, and there's, like, billboards. Nice and...
pack,
this is a huge map. If it goes where I think it is, this map is disgustingly big, dude.
Now, one thing that I like... is that it is a huge map. Now I know one thing that range characters probably won't get use of this map at all.
Yeah. The range characters cannot have anything deemed a large map.
Nope. So
we're moving over to
Site of Planetary
Destruction. Akatsuki's fault map. The Site of Planetary Destruction were all these fights generally give us a good example of who fought here. So this is Sage Naruto versus Pain. I think this is like just outside Naruto, just outside Konoha, where like he stabbed the hell out of Hinata. That was funny. So yeah, you know, Akatsuki, their map essentially. And then this is there's the nighttime version of this. It's kind of just the same, just floating rocks because of Pain. Except he's fighting Obito here. Whatever, sure. Don't care. It's the same map. Literally the same map. Just nighttime. There's no difference. I think it's a medium-sized map. It's pretty good if you have a good jutsu spammer and a good melee set. So if you have that in mind, you can use that in that map. We have the training field map. It's like...
the same
half
map?
Water, half plants. Yeah, it's a half map, but at dusk or whatever. So if you want this map, there's more of them.
It was Kurenai's old stomping grounds. And the amount of water, it's a good map for the mixture of it, because sometimes you're on water, sometimes you aren't. So it's one of those where you get the best of both worlds.
This is the Kurama's seal area, right? It's like inside Naruto.
Now, I can't remember. Was the water on that floor actual water, or was it just an aesthetic? I can't remember.
I think this is aesthetic. I don't think this is water. I'd have to ask R, and I just don't feel like it. So I'm just going to assume this isn't water, guys.
Because I remember that being brought up before.
Yeah, I can't remember. It was a couple days ago. The map's like kind of bum. This is kind of like backsided maps. We have two of the exact same map. I don't know why they did like the like alternate version of the map, because I don't think they're both available, right? I think you get like you pick that map and you get access to both, right? you pick Chunin exam stage, this, the Boruto version, and it gives you the option to pick either the crack or the not crack. This is infinitely better than the Chunin exam stage, because it's the same friggin' map with none of those goddamn trees.
You mean infinitely worse?
Hey man, I'm named.
My team's the one that got it banned.
Trees
okay?
The devil.
You mean Tree Sama?
My team's the one that got that stage banned. That's one of my greatest accomplishments in this league.
This is a relatively medium-sized map, I think. I don't think this one's pretty big. Also, goddamn the staff and their in favorment of those Chia scum. He won that exchange. It triggers me every time.
What's the next map?
Final Valley. This Final Valley Final Battle. Ironically, dumb name.
This is a very beautiful map.
This is a water map. It's like 110% water. Guys.
It is 100% water, yeah.
From mist. Take it.
I'm pretty sure this is going to be one of the most premium maps as far as bidding is concerned.
This is going to be something someone spends their entire money on.
Give certain teams huge stat buffs. It's not going to go cheap.
Yeah, dude. It's pretty small, too, so melee teams can't even consider this. This is the alternate skin for the map Sand was on last year. Mostly water. It's pretty big. There are actually not a lot on this map anymore, because it's Mario. This is considered a large map. So. This map is like Resident Sleeper. I really don't care.
Alright, and then... what's next?
The next map is 424, I think.
Yep,
nope, it's regular Arc 4, not 424. That's later. Yeah, this is like a medium-sized map, so again, it's good for those people who have a good mixture of melee and ranged. It's probably one of the better maps for ranged units. Because there's a lot of corners to clip people in and stuff. This is also really good if you have people not if you want to slot to this if you have a melee centric team, but you don't want to get grabbed a whole ton. So if you're facing let's say Stone, and you don't want grabs to go flying around, you can just go here. This is 424. This is 424. So this is really burn it up then leech.
Yeah,
by the way, that route can stop Pikachu and stuff, so, you know, pretty solid there. And you'd have to be, like, at a really stupid angle, but you could block Pikachu with it. I generally don't like a lot of these maps, just because they're, like, not from me, really. This map is horrible. I hate this map. It's freaking
it is
huge.
Your map,
though. There's 10,000 trees.
Can you go behind these trees?
No, you can't.
I don't know.
No, you can't.
Trees trigger me.
We need more trees everywhere on the map.
Nope, no trees. You can go behind that tree. At the end there, when he's like cheetoring, what's his name, into the ground? You can see that. You can go behind that tree.
This is
a fantastic map. This is
what Itachi and Sasuke
fought.
In playoffs pass, and at least on the old games, the corners really messed people up. It was kind of funny.
Dude, this map is so sick. I love this map, dude. I'm so ready. This map is tiny. It's so good. Word, he's going up against the range team. Slot to this map. Tiny. Ninja Academy Courtyard, I think. Yes. You have Sensei over there teaching these children.
Very emotionless, dead kids and a teacher.
Hey, man.
We should really get someone to help them. They're just standing there.
They've been told that no one in their class is there. They've been told that no one in their class is a leader of a clan to be. What are they called? the, like, the kids of the clan leaders, what are they called?
Oh, this is a returning map, the Samurai Bridge Under.
Pure water map! Guys! Miss sucks! You take this map! Miss will destroy on this map!
This was...
It's also too small.
This
in
was
LA.
Not... What is it? Season 3?
This looks to me like Hidden Cloud's new home. It's small, Hidden Cloud's all melee. It's gonna boost the shit out of them. I think this is something that may even need to be brought up halfway through the season if it becomes too powerful for certain teams.
Yes.
And I like the music change on this right here.
We also don't know if these are available to us to pick. Also, oh yeah, this is the Spousal Abuse map. Let's go. Let's go get him. Oh boy, look at that. Look at that, son. It feels so good to see Greninja Warshika doing stuff. Feels so good. Look at that, non-biased. Yeah, map's pretty small. It doesn't really show it because she's just kind of standing still. Kind of just doing her own thing. That was pretty small. This is Jinshu's map. Sage's map.
It's another good sort of half and half map. If you have some good water stuff, but
yeah,
maybe
but
you don't want to use it all the time.
Now this is a throwback to season 1, and I think season 2 as well. This was Akatsuki's home map.
I thought we didn't talk about season 1.
Hey, I'm just throwing out.
All you guys do is you live season 1.
No, I don't talk about the results of season 1. Because I don't
season
like
one
but
regular.
The maps I will talk about.
Oh my god. This map, FYI, you cannot wall run. I know every one of you is asking right now. No, can't wall run. Unfort. These pillars, can't touch them. As terrifying as they would be if you could, you cannot touch them. This map.
I don't know about terrifying, but I know
think
it would be fun.
You could freak AI out with those. There's so many of them.
Funny enough, it seemed like that map was small, but it's actually a decent
it's
size.
It's pretty medium. It's like a happy medium map.
Madara Shame Corner.
The Shame Corner. Yes, definitely.
This is where he trained Obito to be an ass slave. Awful. You can see it right here, he's getting whipped. No, I think this map is, like, I think it's that size. Like, you can't see it at all, but it looks tiny. So,
it's actually a decent size. I remember Uchiha was testing on it, yeah. It's not a bad size.
This map is medium in length, no water, no nothing. It's pretty existent. I think it's a good map. If your team can make use of it, it's a good map. I think that even melee heavy teams will take this map just because it just works. This map just works. These are the more exciting maps, the Kaguya maps.
Yeah.
I don't know if all these maps are available for us to pick from. I'm certain they're not even, but like
I'm pretty sure they are. A couple of them for playoffs, but generally
yeah, that's what I was thinking. I feel like a few of them are like there should be like one or two that are like switching. Anyway, this map is the biggest of the Kaguya maps, I think, and it's like pretty small. So
I think the Tundra one is the biggest one. Okay,
is it? I thought it was, like, either that one or this one. I thought the final one was tiny. I don't know. Or is it this one is tiny? One of them is, like, a foot long. It's amazing. No, it is this one. This one's, like, a foot long. Yeah. This is, like, a chakra dash long. Disgusting. This map is, if you are a melee-oriented team that doesn't have water-based jutsu, should probably grab that map. It's another one of those maps I think is going to be very, very, very premier, especially with the huge buff to melee, guys.
Yeah, this is the only time you're going to see Kaguya at all, to be honest. sadly, she will never be in a league. Sad.
I wonder how many times they had to record this to not screw up the footage.
Probably just, oh.
I don't, this is so damn dumb. I don't, like, I don't know. Anime, sure. That alt ruins that map for me. I just don't care.
Don't worry, that alt is fine.
At least it's not Itachi's eyes.
Shut up. You will live, okay?
I won't live. The dreams, they don't stop. The maps, I just have nothing to say about medium maps because they're just, medium maps are all the goddamn same, unless they have water. I think this is a big map, if I remember correctly.
Wasteland at Dawn, I think this was a... Buzz, didn't we have access to this map a few seasons ago?
I think it was Storm 2 map, bro.
Huh?
I think it was a Storm 2 map.
Okay.
That was weird.
Huh. But it seems like a decent sized map for the most part. Now you don't actually have like the... I remember correctly, this map actually had like a huge rock. Or like a, like a log that messed with people.
Oh,
well, so.
About to drop that mixtape. Everybody about to listen to Uchiha's new mixtape. Oh, sorry, Katsuki's new mixtape. My bad. But feels good, man. Asuma eating people up, email throwing them bombs. It's collab. Told you with a strike back. And it ends. You just shake all. Hold his foot. You're wet. I'm so biased. It hurts.
I know you're biased. Always. Oh, and then there's another other divine world tree. The other world, divine tree, whatever.
This is what it looks like after Kowski drops his mixtape.
No, just no.
That's fire.
Anyways, I think it's more of a large map, mainly.
I think this is large. I want to say that, or the very smallest, like a heavy medium. But like, all the stuff we see is like, melee oriented, like 2 feet away, so I have no idea. And I think that's the final map. That is the final map, guys. That is it for us. Those are our thoughts on basically everything that's worth mentioning. If we didn't talk about your characters, don't feel salty, because we hate you. I am Shin. I am the, I guess I'm the host. With me, per usual, so he'll be here often, is Tosh. The coach and sound.
Yes.
I'm Buzz. It was great coming on. I'm really looking forward to the season. A lot of the stuff in off season was stuff that came out that addressed a bunch of the concerns I had from the previous season. So I'm quite excited for this. And
it was great having you on, Matt.